Welcome back to my dark corner of this sick world.
Let me see you. With your clothes off.
One of our rare double reviews this week as we look at Barbarian Queen.
My warriors always seem to have trouble with beautiful women.
And its sequel, The Empress Strikes Back.
Women are a waste of time.
Starring Lana Clark in the title role.
I'll be no man's slave and no man's whore.
Preparations for Queen Amethea's wedding are interrupted. First, when her sister is abducted by a garden gnome.
Nothing like a virgin to brighten a man's morning.
Then, by the attack of bad guys from the big city. Who enslave her people. Only Amethea and her friends Estrild and Tiniara remain.
Today was my wedding day. Now the only thing I have left is what might have been. I'm going to get it back.
Not sure that completely tracks, but I get what you mean.
We're going after them.
After rescuing sister Taramis.
That's more like it.
They arrive at the city, where the local resistance leader is patching up an injured man. Oh, my lack of depth perception is making this tricky. The resistance refuse to help, thinking the women are ill-prepared, as they sneak out in Princess Leia's headscarf. Actually, the resistance may have a point.
They got caught.
Which of them?
All of them.
They are taken to the crowded dungeons. You're in luck. A post just became available.
I'm not here to torture you. We have a man who does that.
We're quite comfortably off. We also have a pastry chef. Amethea herself is in the torture chamber.
I made this all myself.
In shop class. It's a spice rack. This is definitely the scene to which the film has been building.
She's a strong one.
You've broken stronger.
Estrild, meanwhile, has been taken to the obligatory orgy scene.
Come on! You are not here to supervise!
Where she finds Amethea's fiancé, who has been made a gladiator and definitely isn't making the best of a bad situation.
All the gladiators you can eat.
He assumed Amethea to be dead and is ecstatic to hear the news.
I can't believe she survived.
This may be why he doesn't play a larger role. They make a plan to get weapons to the resistance, while Amethea makes a remarkable escape.
Stop squeezing! Too tight!
And yes, that is exactly what it sounds like. Amethea and Estrild bump into each other.
You look terrible.
You would not believe what I had to do to get out. Tiniara, by the way, was killed by her interrogator.
Will you tell me now?
Why would I tell you anything now? To be honest, bits of the plan eluded me, but it gets the Dark Corners Return of the Jedi Award for significant nodding. Other than that, it relies 100% on a child knocking down two gladiators faster than an axe can fall. Cue some action. And a happy ending. Except that 5 years later, Barbarian Queen 2 arrived, and I can't wait to see what Queen Amethea did next.
No! Nobody is gonna make a lady out of me!
Well, she upgraded from that grass hut she was living in.
You look lovely, Athalia.
And changed her name. This isn't a sequel. It's a completely separate story on the same theme.
Girls are stronger than you think.
Like Krzysztof Kieslowski's Three Colors trilogy. Not much like, but, you know.
Trust your power to the daughter of such who held it in another time. Trust to me what no man can touch without the blessing of womankind.
This time, Clark's a failure, is heir to the throne, but unable to claim it.
Do you have the power now?
I'm not He-Man. Forcing her to go on the run and join a group of outlaws in the forest.
She's had a rough enough day already.
Once she's proved herself, of course. Oh no, now they'll have to wrestle in the mud. What an unfortunate and unexpected turn of events. Not the most subtle way of ensuring a bit of nudity, but still subtler than the first film.
Close off.
It's a spin on Robin Hood, although it also owes a debt to Jacques Tourneur's The Flame and the Arrow. And apart from dumb guards and a habit of leaving dungeons unlocked, there's only one thing it really has in common with the first film.
It always amazes me that people on the wrong side always accuse the other of being guilty.
At least you got to keep her top on this time.
And see you stripped of the dignity of calling.
Spoke too soon.
What an awesomely disgusting sight.
And Athalia's escape from the torture machine, while very different to Amathea's, is no better.
We'll leave you, Athalia, to think about what you want to tell us.
Should we leave a guard, lock the door? Nah, why bother? The hero, once again, is a problem, but again, a very different one.
She may be right, my lord.
Orion just watches as his longtime crush is marched off, then signs up to marry the new king's daughter.
You'd like to be my king, wouldn't you?
I've never really thought about it.
Without even the backbone to stand up for himself.
I don't like this food. Give me yours, Orion.
Wow, what a pussy. He is second in command of the slave train.
The troops are ready.
Good. Get that rebel moving faster.
But when the outlaws attack...
Don't kill him!
He is spared. As, by the way, is bad guy Hofrax, whom they mock... ...and then send back home.
Why don't you just kill me?
Excellent question. Orion gets slightly different treatment during his captivity. And you might think this is the turning point. Now he's on the good guy's side.
She honestly believes that peasants are as good as we are.
No. In fact, he's put in charge of stringing up innocent citizens.
And I held you when you were a baby.
He's not all bad.
Oh, go easy on her.
Before we hang her. Athalia and friends turn up in disguise.
Let them pass.
So he's a good guy as long as there's plausible deniability. But when Athalia is strapped to the torture machine, I think we all know what he'll do. I'd like to help, but the little woman won't have it.
You're such a weakling.
She gets it. He does, of course, go back later. I brought you a blanket. He does plan to rescue her.
I swear to you, on my life, we're leaving this castle now.
Just after her friends arrive.
Now that sounds like a plan.
And at the end, this is Athalia's happy ending. Just going through the plots and cherry-picking scenes, the Barbarian Queen films sound of a muchness.
What's going on?
Nothing.
But they're not. The first film, for all its faults, its ridiculousness, and its unavoidable perviness, is pacey and entertaining enough. The Empress Strikes Back, a film, by the way, with no Empress in it, aside from one memorable character,
oh, that looks wonderfully uncomfortable.
Is damn near inert. And the ending, which I haven't really touched on, relies on a father being unable to recognise his daughter if she lets her hair down.
Father! father?
Conclusion? They're both stupid, but only one is boring.
It isn't true.
Thanks for watching. For more Sword and Sandal reviews, click here. We don't do a lot of twofer reviews. What other duos should we check out? Let us know in the comments below.
Don't do anything I wouldn't do.